Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Battle Chasers Night War here. We're going to literally pick up right where we left off at the end of the last episode. We got the first part of the password, and now we're going to see what's inside of this giant sewer grate. Maybe it's the second piece of the password. Maybe it's just a bunch of gale weed. I don't know. I ain't going to judge. Enter. A lot of stuff down here. The common parts. Got some gold. Security updates 4-4. Walked by the cellar to find Thomas happily asleep with a red bandit cell wide open. Black of the worst part, whiff gone. Thanks for info. He couldn't care a whiff of what she had says. You gone. There's a simple note. Red lipstick left behind. Thanks for the info. So clearly, the other member of our party is going to be like there. So we can craft a whole bunch of stuff here if we wanted to. We need an OEM energy cell to make for the tank, the cantina. I don't really think we need to have anything like that right now. There we go. Let's head on back. Exit. Yes. I would love to. Sin's voice is like butter. A butter made of fists. Yeah, I could have used Garrison's dash ability that he's got. But obviously, we don't have him here. Wait, is this open now? Why is this open now? I'm confused. I guess we solved the puzzle. There's also a spot down here that we could have gone, but... I guess we can't go down there. Alright, so backtracking we go. I guess that was, like, kind of the first part that we needed to go on. Because we did get, like, it seemed like the first bit of the password. I'm guessing the other one's going to be talks. It's going to be, like, money talks or something. Alright, let's go south. Nope. Yeah, I've already read that. There's a golden scroll over here. Why is Gully so hurt? Oh, these guys are gonna do all AoE, aren't they? I'm gonna use a little bit of mana to get Nature's Boon on everybody. Ice Blast. I'm actually gonna use it on the tank.
Welcome to the Mosh Pit.
Thank you very much for the resub, Edgy Wolf Gamer. Look at that. Pretty happy that, I'm pretty happy that I used Nature's Boon. Eldritch Summons. Oh, we gotta see what this looks like. Opens a portal from another to another plane. Tentacles rise out and damage all enemies. Sure. That's pretty cool. I really hate that thing, like, is guaranteed to stun. Go for a guard punch. Gully's taking a lot of damage here. Definitely need purify. There we go. I think a mass heal would also be pretty smart right now. Alright, we can go for a barrier swing. I am going to be using a little bit of mana here. healing wave or Gaia's fist? Go healing wave. All right, one of them down. Remember, Calibretto gains health back if he gets crit, so not necessarily that bad that he's taking a lot of the damage. Go for the Sunder. There we go. Good crit. One thing I will say, though, is the enemies are starting to hit a lot harder. Found the dungeon map. Yay! Alright, so it's not too big. Wild Collar and an Armored Incinerator. Should probably take the Incinerator out first. I am going to use another... some more mana just to get Nature's Boon out. And this time I will use Taunt on Gully. And that right there is the reason why I wanted to get Nature's Boon out. Forty-seven damage, not too bad. For a barrier swing. Here we can cleanse the burning off of everybody. Gully gave herself the barrier. Are not prepared. That's kind of annoying. All right. Firestorm, Ice Lance, Elemental Shield. Go for Elemental Shield on Gully. And then Gully can taunt them again. Or not, or Gully will just be last to go, that's fine. Good job, Gully. There we go. We're doing, like, a sort of a depressing amount of damage to the enemy team right now. I want to get a Sunder up. As soon as we take the Incinerator out, we are, we're Gucci on that. Barrier Swing, yes. So that's going to ignite and chill the incinerator. Go for a healing Nature's Boon, or we want to go for a healing wave. Healing Touch. Go for a healing wave on himself. Yo, I hate the fact that he dispels. And he heals too? Okay, we have to focus the Wild Collar then. I did not realize that the Wild Collar was healing them. That's something that we're not gonna allow anymore. Let's get one mass heal out. That was the damage shield that we were getting from from Barrier Swing. Now we are done with this Wild Caller. If I had known that the Wild Caller actually was healing, I would have taken him out immediately. This is a pretty annoying group. We don't have any overcharge right now on Nolan, but I kind of don't care about that right now. Here we'll go for a healing wave on yourself. Big Ice Lance. This is a pretty annoying fight, I've got to say. He heals for a lot, and we don't deal a lot of damage. The fact that he dispels the Sunders off himself is also kind of annoying. Should have probably used our burst ability there with Breno. Nolan's in a lot of trouble here. Is he gonna burn again if I use him? Okay, no. I almost kind of want to go for Flame Slug just so we can burst him down. We really need to get rid of that burning, though. Ah. Very funny game. Very funny. Ice Lance him. Oh, down goes Nolan, which is all of our damage. We hit him with a wildfire and obliterate. Let's go for obliterate. We have to take him out. We pretty much have to... Oh, man. We've got to purify here. I really want to kill the Wild Caller. I'm hoping Gully can do it. Well, we're down to Gully. We got the Wild Caller. And he healed as he died? What kind of madness are we talking about here? Alright, it's alright. We got this. We're not losing to this group. Okay, now. We need to mend wounds on yourself first. Gully can take the hits. No, we need a guard punch. Now, he's men wounds on Gully. Gully can use Barrier Swing. This is longer than like some of the boss fights I've seen in the game. I really dislike having to use all this mana, but at the same time, like, I kind of have to. Let's get Bretto up. That way he's up for the mass heal here. All right, Bretto can cleanse that. Okay. We're finally able to start dealing some damage now again. Just took forever. I'm really missing Garrison's damage. We did it. These perk unlock Tank Buster. That fight was redonkulous. We did it. I mean, can't be too salty about it. Ah, take that. These freaking incinerators, man. Alright, Flame Wave is the big AoE, so. It wasn't even a boss fight though, that's the thing. There we go. Definitely want to cleanse the burning because I don't feel like dealing with it. Hello, Hackers. I don't know if there's a way to skip the animations, actually. I do wish there's a way that you could speed things up. I talked about it in today's episode. Well, not this episode, but I mean, by the time YouTube sees this, it'll be 3 days ago. But I do wish there was some sort of way that we could do like a times three speed to speed up through the battles. All right, let's go for Quake Fist. Bring in the ruckus, she seemed to say. There we go. Jared's History of the Junk Town, the Mana Rush. The only two suitable places for seafaring vessels to dock on the island are in the far west and far east. The west was taken by Vansalore and his militia, becoming an official trading and enterprising station, or enterprise station. Those that were less willing to put up with high tariffs and regulations took over the east coast, hence the creation of Junk Town. Hastily assembled Boom Town turned Shanty Town. This rickety place once served as a cheap slum housing for many of the merchants, miners, and dock workers that flocked to the island during the Mana Rush. Hooray. What is this? Enchanter's Table. I didn't realize that we had an Enchanter's Table. Fortress. Increases all defense by 12. That seems pretty good. 0% chance, huh? I do have the materials. Put that on Gully. I guess you do have to hold the crafting button. There we go. Neat. Hit him with the gut punch. Let's see, abilities. Yeah, let's go for a mass heal. No, do we want to go for mass heal? Yeah, I guess. Might not even get it off, actually. Nope. Hey, I'll take that. A flawless victory. Note next to the workstation. I swear I get no privacy here. How is a man supposed to think in these conditions? Come to work to get away from my family. Instead, I get people walking by asking me all the time if their weapon is ready or if their tank is prepared. I need less noise and more me time. At least my indoor station is a lot quieter. So this must be another. This must be a crafting station then. And we have a beacon in here. Here's History Dunk Town. The conclusion: the allure of free trade without oversight was extremely appealing to many merchants. Also attracted to the area were unsavory characters, gamblers, smugglers, and thieves. Became more common as time passed, and Junk Town earned a surly reputation. Double crosses, deals behind closed doors, and intimidation pushed away honest traders, many of whom were left with fond memories of Vance Lore's suddenly reasonable tariffs. There you go. Tome of Knowledge Gully. Does that give a perk? It does. Eat. You got 2 points. Evade chance or crit chance? Critical retaliation, I like that. So if she gets hit by a crit, she comes back with 25% additional attack power. Another one would say, yes, much quieter, much better, just me, my tools, and my tanks. What more can a man ask for? I know this sounds strange, but the tanks have been looking at me strangely lately. They shouldn't have personalities, but I swear they do. They may decide to gather and revolt against me, and if they do, whoever's reading this, please! My one and only prized bottle cap collection is stored underneath a bench between two houses outside. Take the money and donate to a charitable cause. Okay, so we got a bead on where some extra gold is, it sounds like. Power cell. In a container, in a note. That's where the other passwords are. He said between two benches. Trying to battle, sure. Your battle burst is filled. Yay? I don't know if that note with the bottle cap collection was a figure of speech, or they're just being cute, or if it's actually like, come here. Oh yeah, here you go, 300 gold. Bam! Look at that. I guess that doesn't activate until after you discover that from the notes. All right, so we're done here. And we're gonna keep going to the northeast. Yeah, the game's art style is great. The handoff. The boss wants to pack you immediately. No arguments here. The sooner the better. Something about it gives all an easy advantage or invite something smeared and ill-loved. Blah, blah, blah. What is that? A chipped surveyor stone. I don't know what that is. That guy looks pretty big. There we go. Deep iron ring of protection. So that's a huge physical stamina. Should probably give this to Nolan. There we go. I think I shot it the wrong way. So it's a Gun Hulk and a Bandit Scout. The Gun Hulk is almost the size of Calibretto, which is super scary. a tad bit concerned about this. We have our battle burst filled up. Okay, so it deals AoE damage, I guess. Go with another. We should probably do Nature's Boon. Sure, let's try a boulder toss. Nice. All right, so the scout's gone. Let's start sundering this fool. Although we do have four stacks of puncture armor, which I'm kind of worried about. All right, let's go for Ice Lance, since he does have Sunder on him. Here we can go for a Quake Fist. And let's cleanse the four stacks of Sunder off of Calibretto. Big Ice Lance. Okay, I'm guessing that ability just hits people at random then. Let's refresh the Gut Punch. Here we will go with a Heroism, I think. Wow! Okay. So yeah, so getting puncture armor off is pretty important. But I was hoping that Gully would go before the Gun Hulk did. Six stacks of Sunder on Nolan. I don't like this at all. I feel like I should probably be using my damage shield abilities a little bit more. This dude's got a lot of HP. God, those Sunder stacks. Let's try to slow him down. Here we can go for... Let's get a healing touch on Gully. Actually, Bretto needs it more than anybody. Wow! Bretto just cannot take a hit. So that's pretty bad. I think we just gotta try to finish him off. Five stacks of Sunder on Gully. I wonder if we taunt him. I wonder if they, if the bullets stay on just Gully, if we just taunt them. 259. That's pretty awful. Got defense up. Did not deal a lot of damage. Just take him out. Just take him out. I don't care if this uses mana at this point. I just want him dead. Come on, Nolan. We did it. Good lord, man. I don't know if that was a boss or not, but... Man. I mean, again, we are on the very hard difficulty, so I may need to stop doing that, because... Whew, that was rough. Alright, everyone, I'm going to wrap up this one here. A little bit shorter of an episode than the last one, but man, that was rough. I've got to collect my thoughts and figure out exactly where we're going to go from here. So, again, I do appreciate the support on the Battle Chasers series here on YouTube. If you like this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it helps out a great deal to support the channel and the series. Subscribe if you want to get notified when I put new videos live every single day here on YouTube. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!